Hey Cubs, today we'll do sink or float science experiments for kids with dinosaurs, like a real paleontologist. Stay until the end to find out if the biggest dinosaurs could really sink or float.
Let's go!
Hello Cubs, it's me, Mr. Albie. Today we'll do a sink or float experiment with dinosaurs. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I love dinosaurs. I want to be a dinosaur scientist. Oh,
you want to work with dinosaurs and learn more about them? Well, you can start to think and act like a real dinosaur scientist or paleontologist right now. Let's do some small experiments, which are the basics of what real paleontologists are doing today. And recently, paleontologists are trying to find out, did the biggest dinosaurs, like this big diplodocus, sink or float when they were in the water? I'll tell you the answer at the end, but we need to first learn about the basics of sinking and floating. Sinking means when you go down to the bottom of the water. Floating means when you stay at the top of the water. Let's fill up these small tanks with water for our science experiments. We have three dinosaurs here made from different materials. The first dinosaur is made from plastic and it's a stegosaurus. We know this because it has spikes on its tail and plates on its back. We have a Tyrannosaurus rex. This T-Rex is made from cardboard paper and it has big teeth and small arms. Lastly, we've got this dinosaur made from felt material and inside there's a little bit of cotton. It's a diplodocus, sometimes pronounced diplodocus, and it's got a long neck and a long tail. It's very tall. Let's find out which of these dinosaurs sink or float. Which ones do you think will sink or float? Say out loud, sink or float. 3, 2, 1. I'm a little confused, Cubs. I thought the Diplodocus would actually float and the plastic Stegosaurus would sink. Baffling and fascinating. I bet you're wondering, why do some objects sink all the way to the bottom of the water while others float to the top? And it all has to do with density. Dense means that the matter inside an object is closely packed together. All of that matter and stuff is all close together when it's dense. And here we can see that when an object is more dense than water, then it will sink to the bottom. And that's why this felt and cotton dinosaur sank to the bottom, because I think it absorbed the water and just sank right down. But when objects are less dense than water, they float to the top. And that's why the T-Rex made from paper and the Stegosaurus made from plastic stayed all the way to the top because from those materials, they are less dense than water. And so they stay right at the top. Fascinating, isn't it? Let's see if eggs sink or float. We have three different dinosaur eggs to test. The first dinosaur egg is made from ice. Whoa, ice is made from frozen water and it's very cold. Inside you can even see a little dinosaur frozen inside. Next, we've got a dinosaur egg made from sand and dirt. Ooh, inside there's a dinosaur too. And lastly, we've got a regular chicken egg with dinosaur stickers all over it. Now you might be thinking, hey, a chicken egg is not a dinosaur egg, but did you know that chickens are closely related to dinosaurs? Yeah, birds are descendants of dinosaurs that are two-legged called theropods, such as the T-Rex. Wow. Will they sink or will they float? Let's find out. 3, 2, 1. Look at that! The Pachycephalosaurus sunk down to the bottom. Whoa! That means the Pachycephalosaurus dinosaur toy is actually more dense than water. But look at the ice! The ice egg part that's left is still floating at the top because ice is less dense than water. Fascinating. Look at the chicken egg, it sank because it's more dense than water. Let's crack open this chicken egg and see if the stuff inside will actually sink or float. Oh, the inside of it also sinks. So it's more dense than water as well. How strange! The egg yolk sank all the way to the bottom, but when you put the eggshells into the tank, they float. So the eggshells are less dense than water, but the egg yolk is more dense than water. Fascinating. This sandy dinosaur egg has been sitting there because it sank. Let's be like real paleontologists and use our paleontologist tools to check and discover what's inside that egg. I think the dinosaur's about to hatch from this sandy dino egg. Oh, what dino's inside? Let's discover it. Oh, look. Oh, it's an ankylosaurus. It's got an armored body and a hammer tail. Let's see if it'll sink or float. Oh, went straight down to the bottom. It sinks. More dense than water. Cabarific. For our last sink or float experiment, we'll use three different foods that are dinosaur shaped. We have dinosaur chocolate coins. There's a green one, a yellow one, and a red one. The green one is of a Parasaurolophus. And we know this because it has a crest on the back of its head. The yellow one is of a Velociraptor. It's like a T-Rex but smaller, and they're very smart. Third one is an Ankylosaurus. Now this red chocolate coin shows an Ankylosaurus and its armored body and hammer tail. We also have dinosaur biscuit cookies. We've got a T-Rex, a Stegosaurus, and a Triceratops. Finally, we have dinosaur pasta. We've got a Stegosaurus, a Brachiosaurus with a long neck, and a T-Rex again. Which one of these will float and which ones will sink? What do you think?
They will all float.
Interesting. I think the coin will sink while the biscuit cookie and the pasta will float. Let's find out. 3, 2, 1. Ooh, fascinating! Let's compare which foods sank and which ones floated. Let's look first at the coins. Ooh, the coins sank immediately. That must mean that the chocolate coins are more dense than water. Let's look at the biscuit cookies up here. Oh, you can see two of the biscuit cookies are floating. That must mean that they're less dense than water. But what's interesting is that one of them actually sank to the bottom and they're right here. I wonder why. It's probably because that biscuit right there, it absorbed the water, making it more dense than the water itself. And then together with the water and the biscuit matter, they sank. And finally, let's look over here at the dinosaur pasta. Oh, all three of them sank to the bottom. Dinosaur pasta is more dense than water. Coverific! Remember that real paleontologists are now studying whether dinosaurs would sink or float in water. Today, we did some small sink or float experiments with dinosaur objects. Now, let me ask you, do you think that the biggest dinosaurs like this diplodocus, this real diplodocus, would they sink or float?
They will sink.
Oh, most people would think that the real big dinosaurs would automatically sink in water because they're so big and heavy. But did you know that paleontologists recently found that these big dinosaurs would actually float in water? They wouldn't sink. And that's because their bodies are filled with air, and air is less dense than water. Isn't that fascinating? So really big and heavy dinosaurs like a diplodocus would float in lakes and rivers, whereas look, this little light dinosaur made from felt and cotton sinks. Isn't that fascinating? When it comes to science and density, sometimes it's not what you expect. Amazing. It sure was fun to think like a real paleontologist and do sink or float experiments with you. Remember that you don't have to wait someday when you're older to think like a paleontologist or dinosaur scientist. You can do that today, right now. The most important thing is to always be questioning. Be curious every day. See you again soon for our next learning adventure. Bye. Subscribe for more videos and go to cubwings.com to become an official learning adventure cub for free educational activities and more. Bye.